So if you don't have pollination, you don't have fruit. So for every fruit that you get at the grocery store, there has to be the right conditions to get that fruit set. And one of the really hard things about avocado is that only 0.3% of flowers turn into fruit. That's just 3 fruit from 1,000 flowers. If we could just get 6 fruit out of 1,000 flowers, that would make a huge difference. That would double yield for growers.
In terms of improving orchard productivity, the industry average this season has been 10 tonnes per hectare, but we know there's orchards consistently doing up close to 30 tonnes, so we think there's room for movement. Everything that we can do to maximise fruit set and pollination is really important. So avocados are a subtropical fruit. They prefer warmer weather. The cooler springs that we get here in New Zealand can present some challenges for pollination.
Avocados typically already around the world have a really weird flowering system where the female flowers are open and receptive to be pollinated only for a very short window of time. But here in New Zealand, because of our temperatures, that window of time changes throughout the day. So sometimes it might be the morning, sometimes it might be the afternoon, or it might even be overnight. And so what we want for avocado pollination is that we want to have a range of pollinators that are active at different times of the day and in different weather conditions. So honeybees are good for nice warm days in the middle of the day. Bumblebees are great because they forage early in the morning and later in the afternoon, and they also forage when weather isn't so good. Flies are fantastic, they forage at all sorts of different times. And in fact, in Australia, we've found that flies are by far the most important pollinator of avocados. And here in New Zealand, we can think a little bit about how we manage our orchard systems to look after those diverse pollinators that are there. So bumblebees, they're already going to be there in the orchards. We did some work to try and understand what made them successful in orchards, and we've developed a system we hope will be a great tool for growers to actually develop their own bumblebee colonies and use them. For flies, we've got quite an extensive program on developing fly rearing systems, and we have yet to see whether that's going to be practical for avocado growers.
If we could lift our orchard production, it's our biggest driver of orchard gate returns and returns to the grower pocket. So that benefits growers specifically, but also feeds just more money and investment into the whole industry. So it's good for the whole industry.